Hiya, I'm Guntek, and it's time to continue on my Blizzard Badge character. So let's see. When we last checked in, there was a blizzard. Let's see if the game restores that weather state. And that does sure sound sweet right now. I'm not encumbered. I can travel. Carrying the heavy hammer, gonna drop the tools. Maybe. Food. That's not there. There it is. And let's go for a maple run right now. Toying with the idea of going foraging. I still might go to Trappers and see what happens. What I do want to do is to not get lost in the blizzard, right? So, do I have my storm lantern? I left it over here, so swap it for the tools. I won't be reading books right now, so let's drop these so we don't burn them. And I don't need these two. And that should be good. So I have a choice here. I can go to straight across the tracks to the pond. Thing is, if the blizzard ends there, I'm sort of trapped with heavy hammer as my only option. I could go to Trappers, check behind. I wanted to check behind the Trappers before, because there's sometimes a maple there. Maybe it's guaranteed for all I know. It's always been there when I've checked it. And so has that one up on the plateau. Now to get the one that would let me loot out the cabins near the bear, but and I could hit the three or more cabins if they're up, and then go up top. And once up top, I could be stuck there. Let's have a think. I could be stuck there with a wolf, because I heard a wolf up on the plateau, which is new to me, you know. There's never been a wolf up there whenever I've gone there. But that up there doesn't matter. On the other hand, if I go to Trappers, I might get a guaranteed maple without really going anywhere. Let's check what I left at Trappers if I need anything, any of it. Rabbit hides and guts. I would have bought the hides when I... that's kind of weird. The rabbit hides can stay there. Might even drag a deer skin with me, because I have no deer skin clothes left to craft. Anything to drop, securing that goes away. So is the blizzard ending? Not really. Where can I go without getting lost? Because it's very easy to get turned around. I could possibly go all the way around Mr. Lake if it's a long blizzard. Because if I followed the wall, right, from Trappers, I could basically go all the way outside this, all the way along the outside, not hit Trappers, I'd hit the pond. I'd hit the cabin by the pond to warm up, and I'd hit the trailers and possibly the broken down tower. That is worth more to me than going up on the plateau and doing the lake cabins, because I don't think there are any matches in the cabins, and that is what I'm low on. I'm not even sure there's anything for me along all the long way around the map. But after I'm done, I'd end up at the dam possibly. And if not, I can back off to the trailers and probably find a way. Get back here. So, what's it gonna be? I could probably get lost on the plateau, so trappers it is. And I have my flare, right? Yes. So here we go. I should check time of day. So all I have to do is to follow this line out here. And then I have a choice. I can go. Well, the safe choice is probably to follow this. Bottom pedal. Make sure that I point myself straight onto this rock, and the tilt of the terrain should reasonably point me in the right direction. Now I just turned around them. The rock in front of the house. So I've looted this out. Now it says deadfall area, and that makes me unsure. Yeah, I'm still in the right place. Misty mushroom. And then I'm gonna go upwards to get to the right place. Now, I've gone from Trappers to the Mystery Lake to the Forlorn Muskeg exit. There was a birch there, not a maple, so that's been taken. Crappity doo. That's an ankle. That's gonna have to be fixed, but I'll fix it inside. Possibly. Because any sprint I would get back. Do it in the open. Let's get into the cave first. Possibly. And I hope that is not the blizzard ending. If it is, I'm gonna trade. coal damage for that maple, because I need it to be secure. I said cave, but I went straight for here. So blizzard is still going, that's good for me. So it is just about time for another, maybe, weather randomization event. So let's fix the ankle. And why not pop a pill, because otherwise I'll never use them anyway. Now, it all depends on hypothermia. If that was high, I would stay here and warm up. Don't really. Well, if I plan to go on... So I don't know the weather. I could end up at Pensive Pond with predators dropped behind me, so let's do it the right way then. Obviously not going to spend a match on a tea. So that tested the weather. Now it is noon. So, right now I just want to hit the wall and follow that. And then I just... Oh, of course. So the maple isn't yet, but there can also be a birch on this hill. Just behind it. Maybe I'm mixing things up. We'll find out. And if I get in trouble, I follow the wall back. Just want to have a look up here. So don't miss it. Follow this wall all the way around the map, and then I'll be having a high hypothermia risk, so I'm going to be monitoring that. I am truly the blizzard walker right now. By going here, I could miss the cabin, right? So let's not do that. Probably above the cabin right now. So now I'm mildly disoriented, but I could still follow the outer wall, right? Clothing are getting bad right now. Really bad. So that's a hunting blind. And I wasn't really at... This is not what I came here for. So let's stop that. That was definitely worth it. And now we need to get inside. This definitely looks like a weather change though, but I'm close to the cabin, so... Maybe I will be stuck in the cabin with a bear and three wolves outside, who knows, but... I'm gonna look for Maple. With my newfound visibility. I was just pointing my way back to the cabin then. I'm gonna warm up in here. At least I checked behind trappers. No Maple, so it's not guaranteed. Good to know, because that's a high risk. I didn't have the heavy hammer when I was a trapper last time, so that was definitely a too high risk item to take then. Hello, buddy. I was thinking if I can take it back in with me. That would help me. There's a bird down there. Let's grab that too. That's less risk later. That is all I'm gonna take. Unless I see another maple. Tense moments. Now, I do have the flare pistol, but it would be feather in my cap to forge and get back without spending a single flare. I'm gonna set that as a challenge goal. So it should be afternoon at least, but I'm really fatigued right now. Yeah, we got first bow on the floor. Carrying these for no reason. But. So let's get our clothing off. I'm gonna swap that out. Take off. Swap that out. Side now, so I can take those off. Just absolutely need to remember to put them on before going out, and the rest is fine. So, since I still have some time left in the day, I can eat something and sleep. So, I think it's gonna take 3 hours for the clothes to get dry. And I have everything that I came for, so if I want to, I can go back to the camp office or to Trapper's. But it's a high risk though, the back way to Trapper's. Maybe if I hug the wall. Maybe if I like go outside and left up the mountain over the pond. Hug the wall all the way back. Should be warm outside now. But yeah, I don't know the weather 3 hours from now. What I do know is I need to restore condition. So possibly what I should do is eat, drink, and sleep, actually. So what can I do when I'm here? Well, I can warm up. That will take 40 minutes minimum. And I did bring an extra liter of water. I hope it's non-polluted. It's non-polluted, so that will guaranteedly keep me until morning. Now, while I'm here, I would like to go up in the mountains behind me. But I will not do so with this condition. If this is a struggle, I could die. That's only 58%, 59%. Let's check. I wasn't far off. So now I don't need this for firewood. I'd be better off leaving them there. But I do take the cloth. Replace my bandage. So, good stuff. Anything else I can craft right here? Yeah. One of these. There's no chance that I can restore enough condition today. So it's going to be local foraging or something like that. I don't think there's a wolf up there though. Same as last words. Maybe I should just, depends on how fast the clothing dries out. If I can put my clothing on for protection, that would be a good thing. So next up is loot out the cabin. and get on with life. At least now I have a maple on the floor. So, no maple between here, between the dam and camp office, any which way. But yeah, I can go to the plateau as well, check for it. Would probably be a quick and safe option in a non-blizzard. But yeah, I thought, well, as long as you're not encumbered, it seems that you're quite fast. Don't know if that's up to the badge or not, but that's a soda. But at least well, has it helped me out? It didn't speed me up once in a blizzard, and in this but I was encumbered, and in this blizzard I spent a lot of sprints, so maybe that's nothing to go by. Let's try walking with it sometime. When it hits when I'm walking. And then I'll be able to tell if it makes all the difference in the world. If there is maglins, no, there never is after blizzard is there. I'm gonna have a peep. Two corpses, interesting. Yet you can bet you none of them have matches for me. But at least I can have a look. This beautiful visibility. For further maples, but I don't think they are quite a bit a ways over there. I do think there's a chance for maple on the way back there. So I'm really tired with a bunch of hours left on the day, so I could warm up, sleep 1 hour. If my clothing is okay, and visibility, and have a scout up there. Let me treat myself to a Blizzard Walker Fisherman's Friend. I actually think I might find matches in the broken down tower. But that will be a move for tomorrow. I seem to have always gotten wolf when I try to go to the broken tower. No, I don't think there's matches in the broken down tower. Should focus on more maples. Although, I don't need to. But anyway, I can't go back right now, so Let's drink that. And that should let me sleep 1 hour. Hey, for once my stream isn't half a minute delayed. That's pretty cool. So check my clothing, still wet. So the crafted drop stuff dries up faster, maybe? But this is crafted, no. So Mackinaw, why does it say waterproof? That didn't seem very waterproof. It is the outermost, but I mean, these, well, so these are, no, that is less, but I think it was higher than the Mackinaw, so maybe something to go by. Okay. Okay, so let's have a look. The reason I want to do this now is because then I won't have to come back here. It's getting colder. Wow, that cold bar is dropping fast. To make it back inside before it drops completely, because I do not wish to do this then and this. It's better. Should have done that first. Now, I don't think there's a way to get over to the other side. I don't see any maple up there, so let's go back. And besides, it kind of looks like it's gonna fog over. Don't want to be headed off, I can help it. So over here is one of those weird spots. One of the dead spots on the map where you never go. Well, not often anyway. So no maple over here until the as far as I can see. No, actually I think because of all the condition I do, so we'll have to slip back. Okay, eat, drink, sleep. Good stuff. Okay. I was still encumbered, or no? I just got tired. Okay, so let's see here. Good, so make the decision where I want to go tomorrow. Now, if I time myself out, I can sleep back a few more hours, like 3. Because it's going to be cold anyway. And I want the weather to make up its mind. I have no water. No soda. Let's have a look outside. I heard footsteps, I don't know. Probably imagining things, but anyway, I should eat and sleep 2 hours maybe. I have like 1.25 hours left until Maglan's chance to make some water. And a base fire, I guess, a fire to bring. But yeah, let's eat and sleep too. Well, basically, as long as the game will let me. And I should be in better stead. So with that much water, I have options right now. All depends on visibility and location of predators and temps. Which is part of weather, I suppose. Visibility is okay, it's pretty cold. It's pretty cold. Time of day is past first Maglan's chance. So if I want to, I could go check over the side of that hill. Just not sure if I wanna. I'd like to make it out of here in one go, I'd be cold. So if this is gonna be a fog day, I'm gonna have to stay here for a while. Maybe even have to waste a match. But I'd like to get going as soon as possible. Maglans or no Maglans. But it has to get warmer first, so I'm gonna sleep until noon, right? So let's time myself out so I can sleep 3 hours. I should be fine. That is 1 hour. So yeah, if I have to warm up like that, well, I only have to this quick. That was probably the sound I heard. That sounded kind of like footsteps. So, pass. So, 2 hours from now, right? That is fog, I can't go in this. And no moose marks, so that is also checked. Although I couldn't check by trappers, but I will probably go by trappers at some point. So I'm sort of continuously testing a perimeter around my base to get a rough idea, and then I'm gonna sleep 3 hours, which will actually, that is 3 hours. So eat and sleep 3 hours. So let's not forget the maple when we leave. And I still don't know which way to go. Now the most maple are to my left as I exit. I think there's a chance for at least two, three maple on the way back to the dam. But then I'd sort of be in at the wrong end for right now. Because I, well, they could be curing, but I just don't know what I'd do at the dam. Anyway, sleep three. Whoops. Let's see what kind of weather we get. No wind, that's good. How's visibility? It is, if anything, I didn't think it could get worse, but it's definitely worse. So I can't go, I'll have to stay here and take hydration damage or waste a match. So hydration damage, it is. Now, if I make myself tired, I'll pass time until I can sleep 1 hour. And now I'm gonna start taking hydration damage, but it's fine. I'll compensate with food. So yeah, 2.5 liters is pretty much optimal, but I wouldn't have been able to take the storm lantern then probably, because I'd be encumbered. So check the weather first actually. So it is clearing up, so I shouldn't sleep. I should pass time. Clothing is in good shape. So, pass time some more. So, let's make up my mind where I would like to go. I would like to go back home to camp office, because there's a guaranteed maple, I think, on the plateau above the camp office. I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some soda for my throat. Okay, let's see here. Now I would like to peep over the other side towards the trailers to see if there are wolves there, but if I get one, he will bark and then he will stalk me all the way back. I have what I came for. I can do the trailers and stuff later when I have the bow. So let's go to the pond and check it out. Today's drink is Pepsi Max. And no, it fogged over again. So I think there's gonna be a blizzard, which is kinda good, because I can make it all the way back. Well, I could possibly find the trailers. There's gonna be a road up ahead nearby. So that was a tricky one. That was a tricky one. Well, I'll just let the weather make up its mind then. Sleep for as long as I can, taking hydration damage. No blizzard yet. And I can't stay here tonight. So, visibility is super duper. So if I get a blizzard, I get this is the weather to go in. At least you will be able to see until there's a blizzard. So I think I want to cut diagonally across. Why would I want to do that though? Don't see any wolves. I don't hear any wolves. Pretty cold. Well, actually not. Not with my stellar clothing. So if the blizzard hits, I can follow the creek, and if I get a wolf, I can drag him back here and go that way, I hope. So let's see, this turns out to be a sensible decision. Now isn't there always a wolf, right, like, right there? But yeah. If I get him there, he'll be the right side of me to drag him back and go around. It's a human hunt, and I'm the bait. So I think my maple, there might be a maple in the deadfall area. And of course above the trailers. Oh, that's a hell of a stick run. Okay, that was easier than expected. So this maple will cure here and be right here. I might even leave it at Trappers, maybe. Might leave it at the... No, I can't because it won't cure. Just gonna leave it here. Drop. I'm gonna make it a short stay forge, I think. Leave all the stuff for arrows back here. Standard play. Seems good. And there's not enough time in the day for me to go get that maple, I don't think. Plus, there could be... No, it's too late for a short 2-hour blizzard. So actually I have some sprint to work off, so maybe I should go up on the plateau. Check for another maple. There's no rush though. It's pretty warm out. Depends on clothing. Clothing is fine. This mongrel thing. But yeah, doing good so far. Now let's fix the dehydration. Did I see? No, that was outside Trappers. I think it's polluted. Because it's outside, but not close to the door. Or I just dropped it when I needed to go. But yeah, we have a bow on the floor. That feels good. That feels good, man. I do have a bunch of teas. So, let's fix both. See what I can drink here. And we have 2 warm-up bonuses. So I'll drink... Well, then I only have small ones. So, no teas. wish I knew if a tea restores as much hydration as the same as 0.25 liters of water. I think it might. No. I think it's 0.10. So water it is. I have some polluted water here, but that's not gonna be consumed. Need to pick up some more cattails. So they are downstairs. And then once I get the fallen musk egg, I should be able to stop for cattails. Getting down there. I do have some firewood here. Don't need all of it on me though. So let's add to that. And I'll bring the coal. So this is not research, right? Nope. So that is a good use of my time, but I will need to check for maglans. Might be in just a few minutes, so let's pass that time inside to not lose warmth, and then I decide. See, the thing is, I have plenty of fatigue left on me to spend. So I either, I don't know, go on the lake or I go someplace unsafe. Now, I am going to go to the forge soon. Soon as possible. Because I will be spending a match there. So, obviously I can make water there. So should I sprint to the forge right now? I'd probably make it. I would probably make it. That requires some proper thought. If I sprint now, I can't really pick stuff up, and I'd have to waste a match. Well, first of all, I'm not warm. Let's pass some time. Check weather. Don't think I'm gonna get the maglans. So if I have the maglans, I can torch walk, possibly, to the forge. So which route? Well, I have three routes. If there's a blizzard, I'll go not over the ice and not the first left, and if it's good visibility, I'll go across the ice. Probably. Weather changed to something. Mother of God. I had like 1 minute to catch the maglans. Just then. And now I can't, of course. Game is treating me bad. Right now. So right now I have a blizzard, so the same thing applies for the plateau. So the only thing is me getting back without, you know, falling down. I know way from the maple. So let's check temps. Let's see if I can actually do it. I'd probably have to warm up in the cabin, but... Well, when I'm not in the wind, it's fine. Down here, it is cold. So am I distracting myself from my goal by wanting to go get another maple? I think that's greed. On the other hand, it would be a good way to get rid of my energy to sleep my condition back. I don't have to sleep that much condition back. So maybe I should eat and read books. Get cabin fever. Doesn't matter, because I'm going anyway, so... So, let's do that then. Let's sprint now. I should actually sprint inside, but what the hell. It goes faster this way. So just want to sprint myself down a couple hours. So three runs. Three runs will be good, and then... okay, one more run. Because I'm wasting daylight right now. So I'm hoping to maybe read the book. So hydration is good. How's my water? Water is bad. So I definitely need at least half the bar after I read. So, pastime wind protected in the bedroll outside, I think. Or without the bedroll. Pastime, really? Well, I'll pass time in the night. Let's read. Bit of a waste of calories, but can't be helped. I have plenty of calories. I should bring all my cattails even. Well, I should bring some more cattails. So, is that enough for 4 hours? Don't have 4 hours, so it's enough. So, let's read that archery book, shall we? For as long as we can. So I got 3 hours, 4 out of 5, that's good. And now I will be completely depleted of hydration when I go. I'm counting on there being travel weather tomorrow. So I have 15 cattails left to camp off this. After that, I'll need to rely on hunting for food, so... Ready for the big push. Now, the amount that I can sleep right now is the amount of health I will get back. So let's pass until I can sleep 6. That That's the best I could do. I'll probably take some hydration damage at the end of this, but it's how it's gotta be when you're low on matches. So, after the forge, where are my matches coming from? There's nothing at the bear cave near the, well, the cave near the bear cave. There might be matches in the far hunting blind. Maybe. Now, did I test if wolves stand growl at fire barrels? Well, check afflictions, check clothing, sleep 6. And if I can, I'll take the first night lens, and then of course I'll have all the water in the world. Right here at the camp office and can decide what to do. I did not eat before sleeping. That is a setback. Might have to stay here one more day. That's a simple mistake to make. Eat, drink, sleep. Come on, you know how to do this. So now all I can do is pass time until any maglens chance, because I can't really go with this condition. Looks like 73. 71. And I have one stem. I have one stem, and I have this. And I always forget to drink the second warm-up bonus anyway, so why not drink that now? Restore 2 points of condition. Well, I'll do that when I know I don't get a maglens chance. So at noon, or soon thereafter, I will be going forging, maybe. Or if I get a way of making water without wasting a match, I'll stay here one more day. It's all good, just means my maple will be cured when I get back. No idea why I went outside, but yeah. Well, yeah, no. So it is a bit finicky, especially to place the bedroll here, so. Snow in the air, I don't like that. Maybe, just maybe. So music was playing then, so. And was it changed? I just need to do this, because if there's no maglens for the rest of the day, I'm Dehydrating to death or wasting a match. And then I'll have two matches and a flare to forge with, which is not a lot. Please. And now I can pass time outside, maybe. After I check Maglans. Hoping against hope. And I can't afford to lose any more of my health points. Because I messed up then with eating. So the first chance is quite short. That's why I'm doing this. If I could get it, that would be good. And right now I can't read either, so... Nice to see the snow stopping. Gotta check if the bot is up. Oh, it's not saying anything because I'm not saying anything. So it's up. Stop worrying. So now the question is, what do I want to do with my time? Maybe repair up some clothing. That would be a good use of my time. Or harvest this up. 10 minutes, I can do 10 minutes. The alternative is to run to Trappers and get the 1 liter of water. How much water do I have it? Or run to the dam and get a ravine and get all the water I have there. A water run. That is something. But that is what I will do if there is no. Because I need to bring water here anyway. Normally you have like a ton of water here, right? What am I doing? Notes. Trappers. Well, it just says water. No, the snow is still there. Now, if I eat and drink tea, I can read the book. So, but let's check what I can do before that. So at 10 a.m., I'll have to give up, pass 1 hour until noon, and then check weather again. Or I simply go to Trappers, or to the dam, but that's obviously fraught with danger. Danger water. That's 0.4. 0.4. 0.4. 0.3 actually. 0.4, 0.3, there's also this, which is shorter, I think. And we'll give lot 83. So 0.3 and 0.3, 0.6. So Mackinac is best so far. So let's do that. That's going to take 1 hour. So let's do the hat then, maybe. Because I think it's like 30 minutes. Might be 40 minutes, actually. So just pass a smidgen of time. Check the 10 a.m. weather. Still snow in the air. So pass some time. So as soon as it's close to 11 a.m., I know I can read 1 hour. It's getting close to it now. Now I think my chance has passed, but let's do this. Boring repetition once more. Okay, so now I think I know that I can eat, drink, and read a book. So, eat. Drink. Where are you? Would have liked to drink that before bed, but there you go. I could have drunk the other tea then instead. Now it's done, so let's read the book. And if there, oh, I got Archer too. And no Maglans, but it's not quite noon yet, so let's pick up another book. And research. Ah, crappity do. So I'll drop this and maybe carry the Archer book with me. And then I want the big one. Still not quite noon-ish. So yeah, this is boring stuff right now. Now if I get water, which I will, so let's drink the other one. The cattail, read an hour in the small book. It's the same book, just different amount of hours left on. And I need to drink the whole thing, but that's okay. So I'm drinking my only warm-up bonus right now. Should be in first. No, I actually had 2 hours left on it. Okay. So now if there's nothing, I'll read a cattail and read the other hour on it. And after this, after like an hour or more, I'll have to go to Trappers. So, eat cattail, read the book. maybe even drink another small tea just to make it so. That book. It came in with a scream right then. In with a shout, I mean. So now I'm actually in a little better stead because of the birch bark tea. That's fine. So, if I drink two small teas, will I get the hydration bug bump? I might save my arse right now. So, I'm gonna drink one of each of these, right? Or maybe even these are the most worthless, right? Right now. So, let's drink two of those. And if I get the bump, I didn't. Then I go to this. And nothing happened. Chance it. Nope. So, don't know the circumstances. Please God, Maglan's weather someday. I think it might be like one of those other things that the longer you stay in one place. But yeah, I should take tech temps, swarm. I'm gonna go to Trappers and get my water. The last and final. Go over here because then I have options. And I'll be picking up sticks. Should have probably brought all my firewood. I dropped it. But it depends on wolf location right now. Don't hear any wolf howls. Did all the wildlife in here die? Anyway. So the good thing is, now I'll definitely have There's a wolf there, I can drag him with me. So I should pick up stones. I should go between the hills, of course. But now if I use my last stone, I'll get past that wolf, unless there's another one. Over to the left. There isn't one over to the left. Oh, he went left. Okay. Fuck you. Sorry about that. So when he went there, I should... Fuck! But I'm not encumbered, so I should be able to drag him with me. That's the bear. And no moose marks that I can see. The whole menagerie. By the cave just to have it available, but if I won't go in there if the path is free to the cabin. So there might actually be Maglan's chance right now. And it's really super short, so let's get wind protected and light the Maglan's fire right now. Frig! Frig! Frig this game! Fuck this game. Start fire. Beautiful. Oh, never mind. I'm happy. Take this fire in first. I hate this game sometimes. But that's probably because I'm tired, because I've been tired all day. So let's transfer this, put on some coal, and steady ourselves. So tomorrow we're going to the forge, that's good. And I'm gonna end the stream pretty soon because nobody's watching. So this is normal play. It looks like I'm in trouble, but you know, just being careful, that's all. Maximum amount of water right now. There we go. Amazing. Light the torch. Actually, not. I'm gonna do... Except I threw my last stone. I was hoping I could scare away the wolf from the carcass. Okay, he left dead, so... We might be able to get it later. Now then now. What did I leave here? Look at all the water I left here. Should have picked up more water. I would have been encumbered. Would have been worth it. So this, almost all of this, is brought back to base. And that is sweet, because now we can sleep back this condition loss. Just go to the camp office when it's in the cold part of the day. Then... I will have to look out for that wolf, though. So that can actually burn out. Do I want that, though? Or do I want to use this precious maglans as much as I can? The sweet nectar of God. So, snow in the morning, don't bother waiting, right? And if you travel, you might get it when you're traveling anyway, so just grab it and cook. Seems good. So that is actually good. Now, if I do another round, I need the firewood for it, so... let's take something. That'll give me 3. That will get me almost there. And with sticks, not quite. So I'm looking at 45 and 30, so 115. And that should be plenty good enough right now. There are 9:47. That is pretty much perfect, so... Need a cattail just to stop the rot, and then... I can sleep back. Oh, my condition! And that is... awesome. So let's do that inside for today. And then if I can get the rabbit, I can cook that. But he will have eaten all the meat, right? So no point. That is not enough, obviously, so 2 hours. Actually do this. And I can even take a torch. So let's grab the rest here. Tons of stuff. Firewood for days. So now I can actually go to sleep, but it's not late enough yet. In fact, I could read my skill book or break down something with tools. I can only read 1 hour on the... I didn't bring the skill book, so breaking down with tools for 1.5 hours. So if we can find something that is 1.5. To do it in pieces then. So 45 and 22 and 22, that's 1.5. And then I can do maybe some more water on there. 1 hour seems good. Take the shelf. Take another shelf. That shall be perfect. And then if I want, I can break down even more stuff here and either leave it here or leave it at the Fallen Musk Egg exit. So let's do half and half, just to not waste too much firewood, and then just one reclaimed is enough. That gives me options, because then I can decide what to do. So yeah, I have plenty of water on me. It's all gonna come back with me, so I don't have to go through that again. And now I'm pretty much ready to sleep, but I will have to sleep for 10 hours, of course. So let's sprint around inside here to get tired, right? Cabin fever risk is okay. So it might be that breaking down stuff inside has a higher cabin fever risk, but maybe not. So let's craft something if we can. Yes, we can craft. That'll be boiled. Then I can choose if I want to do that again, and I guess I do. So, water, water, reclaimed. That is good. And then sprint some more like we did last summer. So can break this chair down still? No. It's a magic chair. Jeremiah's chair, I suppose. Can't touch it. And I'm pretty sure I can't craft anything right now. So take another shelf, I suppose. Actually, I'm pretty much ready to sleep right now. Check. Should be good. But I guess if I take the shelf, I can sleep 10 hours properly. That is good. Excellent. So do I bring one pot back to the camp office? I think I might. Then I have three there, which makes me able to take better advantage of, well, cooking a shorter time. So how's my cabin fever? Is still okay. I'm gonna sleep inside, I'm gonna sleep 10. So eat, drink, sleep 10, right? This all comes back with me. Maybe I'll drop 1 liter, depends on weight. There you are. Sleep. Now, if it's a blizzard, I might go to the camp office right away. But there isn't. Now, how's my water supply? 5 liters. That should reasonably be enough, right, to catch a maglance here. So I should make enough water to catch a maglance. That means, I guess you go through 2 liters a day, so let's drop 1 liter. That gives me... Oh no, and I got cabin fever. I should have just gone out. Rest or drop some of your gear in order to eliminate the sprain risk. Okay. Cabin fever, do not sleep indoors for 24 hours. Spend some time outdoors to recover. So yeah, I'll be going back to the camp office. And now I can break down all the stuff in here if I want to, until I get the weather I want. And then I can go to the camp office. I just got it by going inside again. My god. Okay, but that's good to know. You don't want that. You don't want like 28% or 30% cabin fever. I think it was 25%. Well, I can't see it now. Because then you can't sleep 10 without getting it. So, but that's no problem. But it will mean that I can't go forge today. So let's spend the day in here. Work up our cabin fever. So I'll be breaking some stuff down here. I'll take that. Break you down. Might have missed the magma chance. Well, it's a foggy day. I heard some footsteps outside. That is interesting. So I'm looking for a safe way to get back to base. Or at least a warm one. Because I'll need to be asleep in the cave tonight, and that means I can't drop too much condition. So next chance at noon, so guess there's nothing. Well, I can take this with my hands. And then it will be noon. ish. We'll test the weather with this. And if not, I'll do 2 hours on something or two small pieces. Super foggy, that's gonna be a while to clear. Looks like a repeat of the weather day before last. So, drink, eat, take something big. So foggy. So I'm gonna spend as much of the day here as possible until I get the weather I want. And that's probably gonna be the evening, either clear weather or blizzard. Either is fine with me. So I can take the table too. Just want to cut down on my condition loss. Because now I have cabin fever, now I can't build it up anymore. So, did the fog clear? The fog cleared, and it's warm. So I can reasonably go. I should go, right? So, should I leave some firewood here? So, which way do I want to go? I know there's a bear by the bear cave. I know there's a wolf on sort of the Milton Cave side of things. But once I'm past that wolf, he will probably go back to where he was. And I can hug the wall for a bit and then go across. I'm going to hug the wall, I think. Because then I have a path back, and then I can drop off some of the reclaimed. So how much am I? So can I still sprint? Yes. Not going to be super fast. But I am encumbered, so I'll drop like a couple kilos here. Obviously not dropping any of the water. I have reclaimed at the camp office. Maybe I should leave most of it here. And drop half, see what that does. And the tinder plugs go in here. And that should put me under. No. I have a kilo left to drop. I'm not gonna drop water. I'm going to drop something else. Do I have more torches back? I don't think so. So what do I drop here? The pot would put me under, of course. So maybe have 2 pots here then. No, I didn't pick it up. So 3 torches would put me under. Let's do that then. And I have 5 for torch walking until I have to make a new one. That should let me sprint a little faster. So let's go. Why are there no stones here? relevant unnecessarily. So is it wise to cut across? It is maybe fogging over a bit. No wolf or bear there, that makes me worry. Yeah, let's hug the wall. It's a deer, that makes me feel safer. Haven't heard a wolf howl in days, that makes me worry. So he's telling me you're free to go. Which probably means I should go where I can see far. Thank you. So this is my cut across. In case he's on the other side of the tracks, so I go across again here. And if so, then I'll be able to fix my sprain and sprint a bit maybe. So the forge was delayed, but once I make it to the camp office with the water and firewood, so why did I just do that? Well, makes me less encumbered. So I thought I would fix my sprain, but I didn't have to, so. Good stuff right there. So, is there another Magnus chance today? No. If I eat, I can read the book. Nice to see our research on it. So, that one is firewood. So I will not have many coal with which to forge, but I will probably find some at the wagon if I go that way. So that should be good. And that is pretty much it. Need to get tired, but that's no problemo. So drop a couple liters down here. have a bunch of reclaim to bring with me. Might not be able to carry it all. We'll see. I'll have the same loadout as now. So, what I could do actually is repair up my hammer. If it takes 1 hour, so... I don't have a fur, do I? Here, anyway. I wouldn't have lugged a fur around, so... But because it's warm, I could take a fur with my hacksaw, but that would make it too late. So, maybe eat and read the book. How many hours left? 4. Haven't decided yet. Probably I should leave this here when I go. So I can read that later. Drop the tools. So what day are we on? So I only did 3 days today. Well, 4 when I sleep. So if there's no wolf here, I might try to take a fur. How do I feel about that? And also, I can't sleep inside. So what I should do is get some reclaimed waste in the cave. And head to the cave when it's time to sleep. So that hit in the morning. So in the morning, I'll be good. So I should be doing as much crafting and stuff inside as I can. So how about taking that fur, then it will be 2 a.m. and then I can't use my hacksaw anymore. But I could go inside and craft something maybe. I could repair clothing though. And if there's a blizzard, it's fine. I can still go to the cave, I suppose. That should reasonably do me until morning. Still fine. So I'll check, scout ahead. And if I don't get a bark, I should be safe here. Take this fur, right? That's a cedar though. So what about the one near the camp office? I think that's a cedar too. Well, if I can't, I can't. That's just how it is. It is getting dark, maybe I should head on over to the cave. How's my food? Food is okay-ish. that's a cedar, so it doesn't help me, so let's go to the cave. So, if I can, I'll repair up the bedroll if it needs to be done. Nope. My clothing is just as before. So, how long does this take? 30 minutes. Do I have 30 minutes? I might squeeze it in. So, let's see if we can find some rabbit pelt and a gut. So, how's my firewood? I'll need more. That's fine. Can take the reclaimed outside. So let's do that. Fuck. So I'll repair it tomorrow then. Now I've definitely spent. Well, it says you can't sleep inside, but you should be able to pass time inside, right? So let's do that until I get tired enough to sleep, because then I don't have to sleep for as many hours. That's the door. And then I should remember to bring firewood to the cave. Pass 1 hour at a time. Oh, you can't. So they thought about that. So all I can do is craft. So let's do that. Little does the game know that this counts as passing time. I could probably break something down as well. And I think I took all the small ones. Okay. Now the blizzard is fine. The blizzard is fine. So well, to give I can stay awake until the morning, probably. Just pop over to the cave to sleep. Sleep like a few hours. I always, you know, played it differently. I played it like, oh no, disaster, cabin fever. But it's not a disaster. And I could even make water if I wasted. I could make like several 2 hour chunks of water. But I should be able to pass time like this, right? No. But if I waste a stick, I mean a match, and some firewood, I could make tons of water. Go sleep in the cave in the morning and be just fine. Right now I'm waiting for the blizzard to end. But I think it might be a long one. But I guess I do want to be rested in the morning. So right now I can sleep 7.5. And that will wake me up. Before morning. But that's fine. Let's go for the crown. I won't be breaking down anything, but just a short one to do something. I guess I could go here. Cause I'm wind protected here, so I could do this tunnel. Mm-hmm. Until I get cold, of course. So I think I wanna sleep like 5 or 6 hours. Why is the blizzard always howling down this tunnel? I've not been in a blizzard where it hasn't. And now I actually have to head back. Well, I will be sorry. So is this faster than normal? Maybe a little bit, maybe not. Well, I thought about arranging the water bottles, but not really. So, do I have both my pot and can? Yep. So, if I drop my torches, I could harvest them to pass a few minutes to warm up inside. So that is halfway cured, so that will be cured when I get back from the forge, just in time. And if there's a few percent left, I can no torches, so yeah, that's my yawn. The stream is about to end, better end it pretty quickly. Just gonna wait for my cold bar to rise and I should be fine. So do I have 5 torches. That's gonna have to be good enough. And then mm, might be able to repair the pot, but I think I need the simple tools, so maybe not. So I guess I throw a couple stones at the first wolf pass, a couple stones at the next wolf pass, and then I'll be able to pick up more stones when I enter Forlomaskeg. But I have two whetstones, that is excellent. That was Pog. So, it is looking up, it is looking up. Second yawn. Thing is, I want my clothes to be dry and myself to be warm when I sleep in the cave. To max that out. Now, can I repair clothing with a fishing tackle when it's dark? Let's try that. Because why not? And the Mackinaw was the best, right? So. One sewing kit on me. Should definitely pick that up then. Yeah, no problem. I can repair up my clothing until morning, basically, and then. But I don't want to sleep. Now I need to sleep 9 hours. So I didn't check the time on that. It was probably 2 hours then. So let's have a look at the Mackinaw. Actions. Oh, I can't see that now. Okay. Should have done that instead. But now it's fine. Now I'm warm and I can sleep 9 hours. But I don't have to sleep that many in the cave. But I should still get 6 hours of firewood with me. Still haven't used a match. So that takes some skill. So, sewing kit. Oh, I'm upstairs. I thought I was by the workbench. So why not? So that is very interesting. You can repair clothing inside for a hefty time penalty in the dark. I think I've always used a sewing kit. So strange that you never find those things out. So anyway, 9 hours of fatigue to restore, and I have no coffee, so I need to sleep like 5. So, food, water, and firewood. That is 2 hours. So I need 8 more. So let's head to the cave. Sleep 6 hours, should be good. I can do it in concessions to conserve firewood. That is comforting to see. But yeah, I couldn't really get lost from the camp office to the cave. Those are okay still. So here goes another match. I'll obviously be making tons of water for this, and I'll sleep in 2-hour sessions. Probably until the cabin fever clears. Because this is my Magnus fire, so I don't have to. I can stay in this cave for as long as I want. Well, I can stay here for 10 hours, probably. Brought my other pot though, but it's fine. Cook. Now I know I have to keep this going for 6 hours, so... that should be fine. Eat, drink, sleep. Actually, I do want to kind of be warm until that happens. That is good. And then I'll get rid of the cabin fever. Now, I may have to forego this water. In order to sleep 6 to get my health back. Yeah, so... the main thing is this should be alive when I wake up, and then I'm gonna check for non-windy weather. So let's pick that up again. Alright. So, do I sleep more than 6? I'll sleep 7 then. That's gonna wake me up at noon. So, 7. Thing is, I'll be sleeping through the coldest part of the day. So right now it's 46 degrees in here. That should reasonably keep me safe. 46 degrees. Yeah. So eat, drink, sleep. Now the music is playing, so maybe the blizzard will end. And then I will be super safe. That is plenty to sleep 7 hours. So drink and sleep 7. I'm making absolutely sure about these decisions because otherwise I die in my sleep. 46 degrees, 7 hours, sleep 7. Check clothing. No wet clothing, good, sleep 7. And the blizzard ended immediately, so I should be safe. So, actually, after the cabin fever, I got cabin fever risk. So, depends on weather. And temps. Wow, I got a bonus on that. I wish I knew that. Why didn't I get all my health back? So I feed this fire, right? And sleep for as long as I can. I don't really have to reduce fire risk, but let's check how much fight time I have left on that. 3 hours. Where'd I get the bonus from? That's just weird. Well, so if I can sleep 3 more hours on this and get another bonus. So yeah, let's ditch the water again then. Because I can sleep 3 and then I'd be completely cured probably and ready to go. Last stick, I'll find another outside. Eat, drink, sleep. Slow decision making right now because I want to be alive if I can help it. Let's eat one more cattail for good luck. I'll sleep for 3 hours. Sleep. So, right now, I'm hoping for no wind so I can bring this fire inside. That was pretty close. So, now it's just afternoon. Weather will be warmer from now on. So yeah, I'm ready to forge. Let's see if that's a cedar or a fir. That's a fir. Good to know. Couldn't have grabbed it either way. Didn't have a chance to listen where the wolf was, but maybe when I get out of range he will. Beautiful weather. So this is now prepared to just go forge. Next stream. At least I'm counting on, wow, 4 rabbits up here. Maybe 5 if there's another one up there. They can be my, you can be my bodyguard. And I could be your long lost pal. So I really need to sleep right now. So unfortunately no fort today. I would just be able to make it there, I think. So, but this is fine. This game. Really? Boil this water, put it on the kettle anyway, and make a save. Take a torch, all that good stuff. So that lost me torch, but this gives me an opportunity to get some good torches on me. That's why I changed my torch just then. I would have been sad. And I have even more polluted water here. Now, I won't have to bring much water with me to the fort. That's good. So, let's cook this half and half. Water, boil. I have 1.6, so I should make like 0.8, but I can't, so it'd be 1 and 0.64. Or 1 and 0.5 in the can. Because then I can leave this here. I shouldn't think so much. And then drop tainted water in the corner game. Then I can make warm-up bonuses as well. But then I'll have to go. Cabin fever risk is low, and it's gonna completely disappear, of course. So let's get the time on that. 20. This is fine. This is fine. Okay. So make notes. All I can do right now, actually put some more sticks on because if I had a fire burn out by just going outside and in again, creating a safe point. So I shouldn't get back-to-back buses, but you never know. And that's my save point, and I'm gonna thank you for watching. Bye-bye.